Economy report tonight, barring some sort of last-minute compromise between Congress and the White House, millions of college students will soon see a significant spike in their college loan interest rates. On July 1st, the rates on a government-subsidized Stafford loan are scheduled to double from 3.4% to 6.8%. And for many, that is a scary thought. WMTW News 8's Steve Minich takes a closer look now.
I'm excited that I get to go to the college of my choice.
Daring high senior Dylan Farber's heading to the University of Denver, his top choice. It does, however, mean he'll be racking up thousands of dollars in student loans.
I don't particularly want to come out of school in debt, but it's going to happen.
Debt, which millions of college students across the country struggle to repay. And now, with interest rates on government-subsidized Stafford loans apparently set to double,
I think it's potentially devastating.
High school guidance counselor Tracy Moore advises students and parents on their college choices. And while potentially devastating to current college students, she also believes there needs to be a better balance. And a sizable increase in interest rates could finally have more families taking a closer look at what defines the best college.
I think families and parents, first and foremost, need to be very proactive about what they can afford.
The whole cost was pretty much my number one decision.
So Billy Farrell opted for his second choice, and though he'll still be taking on debt to attend St. Michael's College in Vermont, he believes the trade-off is worth it if it's a college he'll enjoy.
It'll make the loan less severe than if you just go to a college that you don't have as good of a time with, but you have less money.
But many wonder, how much more debt can a young college graduate take on? Already, according to the Institute of Access and Success, last year's college seniors graduated owing an average of about $27,000. In Portland, Steve Minich, WMTW News 8.